Welcome to the Math 1 lesson summary video for the task Geometric Meanies, a practice understanding task. So the purpose of this task, if you can look with me at the top, is to solidify student understanding of geometric sequences through the process of finding missing terms in a geometric sequence. So remember, the key aspect of a geometric sequence is that it has a common ratio, a number that's being multiplied by each number in the sequence to get to the next number in the sequence. So I can look here at table one, and my instructions ask me to find the missing terms of the geometric sequences represented by the table. And I can think about, so I want to multiply 3 times something to get a number that I can then multiply by that same number to get 12. So let's just say I use a guess and check approach, and I try 3 times 3 is 9. 9 times 3 is not 12, so that's too much. Let's say I try times 2. 3 times 2 is 6. 6 times 2 is 12. So in this case, my R was 2. I was multiplying by 2 every time. And so that guess and check strategy will work pretty well. Is the missing term that you identified the only answer? Why or why not? And so the question there is there another number I could have multiplied besides 2 that would have worked? And it may not be immediately obvious that there is, but I could also multiply by negative 2. That would give me negative 6, and then negative 6 times negative 2 would give me positive 12. So R could be 2, or it could be negative 2. Some students may think about it this way. They'll say, okay, I know I'm starting at 3, then I have to multiply by some common ratio one time, and then multiply by some common ratio another time, and then I'm gonna get 12. And so a simplified way of writing that equation would be 3r squared equals 12. This is more advanced of an equation than we're expected to understand at this point, but I'm just showing you this for your future benefit. So divide both sides by 12, just like you would with a linear equation, and you can get r squared equals 4. And so these make sense as the solutions to that equation, because 2 times 2 is 4, but negative 2 times negative 2 is also 4. So when you square root both sides of an equation, which is what we'd be doing here to solve for r, you have to take the positive and the negative square root in your answer. And that's something that you'll learn much more in depth later when you're learning about quadratic functions. So that for right now is just a preview. So then let's consider table 2. If we use that same equation writing strategy, so I have to multiply by R 1, 2, 3 times starting at 7. So I have 7 times R times R times R is going to equal 875. So that would be 7r cubed equals 875. Now I can divide by 7 on both sides and get r cubed equals 125. And if we think about it, what's a number that I can multiply by itself 3 times to get to 125? We can figure out that r must be 5. So then, are the missing terms we identified the only answers? Well, so 7 times 5 would be 35. 35 times 5 would be 175, and 175 times 5 would in fact be 875. So we can use that strategy to solve this table. Does negative 5 work? Well, let's just try it. So if I made it negative 5, well then 7 times negative 5 would be negative 35. And negative 35 times negative 5 would be positive 175. Multiplying by negative 5 would give me negative 875. So in this case, that strategy doesn't work. The negative doesn't work. So are the missing terms we identified the only answers? Yes. And we can see that from my work shown here. So the negative version of the common ratio will work in situations where you're multiplying an even number of times to get from the given term to the final term, but it won't work in situations where you're multiplying an odd number of times. So in this case, r equals 5, as we showed down here, is the only possibility, and that allows us to fill in the table. with these two values, which are the only possibilities. So fun fact, you could also solve this equation here algebraically by doing the cube root in your calculator, because cube roots are the inverses of r cubes, but that's much more advanced than is necessary to understand in Math 1. Thank you for watching. If you need specific help with your Ready, Set, Go homeworks, please check out the Ready, Set, Go aligned support videos in the student support site in Canvas.